Well, on the other video, I was testing this 1920s crystal set with a cheap set of headphones. Unbeknown to me, they weren't terribly good, but this time round, I've acquired a set of 1920s brands superior headphones, which needed a new cable. Other than that, the magnets and the diaphragms are still okay. Very nice piece of artwork on the phones there. As I say, they're a very distinctive 20s design. I've just put an old telephone cable on there, contemporary with the date. But these are much more sensitive. They've got they're 4,000 ohm. They're 2,000 ohms wired in series to give you 4,000, which means you get more sensitivity. And I simply connect them up, and again, if you get surprising results, actually, considering the age of them, they're nearly 100 years old. So if you tweak the, I've got an aerial running, you can see it's probably running straight out the window there to that fence post, and the earth is connected to the sink unit there, just by a piece of wire on the earth terminal. And if we give it a little bit of a tweak around, see if I can get up a little bit nearer there. There we go. You've got to get the whisker. This is called the old cast whisker. You get them, you tickle it until the Gelina crystal there. You see the wire. You catch it just right, you'll just get the signal. And there's again, we're not picking up too many radio stations with the tuner, but. If you turn him just towards the right, say if you put him up to the headphones there, if I put it up to the earpiece, you can clearly, distinctly hear. Say it does go out, you've got to keep fiddling with the whisker, but I think that's quite amazing for something that's nearly 100 years old. To say, on eBay you can pick these up for next to nothing, because usually what happens is the wires break, but you just have to find a bit of old cotton covered wire and just rewire them. As long as you wire them in series, they'll work fine. Thanks for watching, hope you found it interesting.